So, Ria, how are you feeling now?
Doctor, my left knee is still paining a lot and it's sore. And I can't even move my left hand. I'm not feeling well. But honestly, I'm also a bit happy. I'm gonna get a few holidays from school.
Yeah, dear, you see, I mean, you are hurt right now and it is paining. You might be feeling unwell also, and because of the bandage, you may not be able to move your hand freely. But there is no need to worry, okay? With the medicines I have prescribed you, pain will reduce soon, wounds will heal faster, and you will be able to move your hands very soon, okay? So there is no need to miss school, and you can also visit your friends and play with them. Yes, you just have to be a little bit careful about that, okay?
Really, doctor? My friend Nisha has also been unwell and she's been missing school. You know what? Her brother told us that she's having fever, cough, and cold, which is why she's been told to rest at home. And
Okay.
you know what? Her mother isn't even allowing her to come play with us since 2 days.
Well, maybe Ria, it is because Nisha is unwell due to some infection, flu maybe, and because of that, she is prevented from interacting with her schoolmates and friends so that her infection does not spread with other healthy children.
What does that mean, doctor? Both Nisha and I are unwell, but I can still be with my friends and she can't. Why so, doctor?
Yeah. You are a very bright child, okay? You raised a very apt question. Now, let me try to explain you, okay? Now, see, both you and Nisha are unwell, ill, and sick right now, okay? You may both be suffering from pain, irritation, and discomfort, but there is one major difference. See, Nisha has acquired an infectious disease, and you have acquired a non-infectious one. So while Nisha is sick, she can't mingle with other healthy people because there is a chance that others might acquire the same infection from her and become sick.
Oh.
But as are you suffering from non-infectious disease, other healthy people coming in contact with you will not acquire the disease from you. And in other words, your disease won't spread to healthy people.
This is very interesting. Does it mean that we, the humans, suffer from different types of diseases?
Yes, indeed, Ria. You have phrased it very correctly.
Doctor, can you please explain to me more about different kinds of diseases that we suffer from?
Yes, it would be a pleasure for me to explain a smart child like you. So let us begin. And yes, if you don't understand something, feel free to ask me anytime. Okay?
Okay, doctor. Now please begin.
Okay. See, sometimes we experience departure from state of well-being in our body and mind. Okay, this could happen in form of our experiencing pain, fever, discomfort, restricted motion of body part, restricted ability, or reduced capacity of some part of our body to function. At other times, it may appear as some irritation in behavior or unsettling emotions or feelings that cause displeasure. So see, whatever be the reason, we feel not at ease with ourselves. This is what we term as disease, or as better put as dis-ease, simply meaning not at ease.
So, is it right to define disease as a disturbed state of body and mind that can lead to physical and/or physiological dysfunction or malfunction?
Yes, that's right. See, diseases may arise due to variety of reasons. Broadly speaking, of there are two types of factors responsible for causing of diseases. The first one you can say intrinsic factors or internal factors. Now, what are these? This means there is some deformity, dysfunction, or defect within the body or mind right from the birth of an individual. There could be some defect in some organ or body part due to improper development of embryo to fetus. It could also arise due to certain heritable defects, mutations in genes or chromosomes that carry the genetic material. Now, diseases arising from such causes are termed as congenital diseases, which means diseases present since the time of birth of an individual. Well, the second term is extrinsic factors or external factors. Now, this means that some factors from the environment are affecting the body or mind and responsible for causing disease in an individual. These factors could be physical agents like heat, pressure, radiation, chemical agents like smoke, pesticides, toxic gases, industrial waste chemicals, acids, or biological agents like bacteria, fungi, parasites, insects, pollen, or spores. etc. Like such diseases that arise from factors picked up or acquired from environment are termed as acquired diseases.
Doctor, can you please tell me a few more features of congenital diseases which will help us to distinguish them from acquired diseases?
Yes, there are a few simple features which are unique to each category of diseases. We will see this in a tabular format. Okay, so now see, congenital diseases are present in an individual at the time of birth, and acquired diseases, they develop in an individual after the birth.
Wow!
The causative factors are present within the body of an individual, and the causative factors are acquired from the surrounding of an individual. Congenital diseases are hereditary in nature and may be transferred from one generation to another, whereas acquired diseases are never hereditary and cannot be transferred from one generation to another.
Okay.
Many of these diseases are still untreatable or uncurable. Most of these diseases are treatable and curable by some therapy. Some examples of congenital diseases are Down's syndrome, sickle cell anemia, hemophilia, muscular dystrophy, cerebral palsy, to name a few. And whereas some examples of acquired diseases are typhoid, rabies, burns, allergies, food poisoning, common cold, fractures, AIDS, cholera, etc., to name a few.
Thank you, doctor, for sharing this useful information. I understand now that the wounds on my leg and the fracture in my hand are both temporary disabilities, which I acquired when I fell on the playground.
Correct.
I also remember that our youngest cousin brother Rahul, he has 6 fingers on his left hand. Am I right in concluding that it is a congenital disorder?
Absolutely correct, Riya. Though it's an abnormal congenital condition that Rahul has, it is not a disability or disease.
I get it now. But I have a doubt.
Please do ask.
Is there any other way to group diseases apart from the nature of their origin or causes?
Yes, indeed. Many a times we also group diseases based on duration of onset of disease and the time required for individual to become free from the said disease. Accordingly, diseases are grouped as either chronic or acute.
Now, what does that mean, doctor?
Okay. See, chronic diseases are the one usually affecting an individual for long period of time with low to severe intensity, whereas acute diseases are the ones affecting an individual very intensely within short period of time.
Can you also share with me what are the various parameters that will help us to distinguish between chronic and acute diseases?
Sure, yeah. There are important differences between the nature of chronic and acute illness which will help us to understand them better. See, chronic diseases usually have a very slow onset, and acute diseases have very sudden onset. Chronic diseases progress very slowly in the body of affected individual, hence such diseases may last in the body for a long time before becoming very severe to be noticed by affected individual. Whereas acute diseases progress rapidly in the body of affected individual, hence such diseases become very severe within a short period of time and are noticed quickly by an affected individual.
Oh.
Chronic diseases may also take long time to get completely cured and for affected individual to become healthy again. And acute diseases are usually cured comparatively faster and affected individual quickly becomes healthy again.
Okay.
Some examples of chronic diseases include arthritis, hypertension, diabetes, certain cancers, asthma, etc.
Okay.
Some examples of acute diseases include burns, flu, typhoid, allergies, heart attack, etc.
Thank you, doctor, so much. I appreciate you taking this time off from your busy schedule to do so.
The pleasure is mine, dear. And do share this knowledge with your friends too, okay?
Okay, I will.
Yeah. Chalo, bye-bye. Have a good day and a very speedy recovery too, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, and yes, don't forget to take medicines without fail. Yeah?
Okay.
Chalo, bye-bye.
Bye.
Yeah. Yeah, send the next patient. Thank you.